All right, welcome back to your balanced diet of Teletime. Thanks so much, Bernard, for giving us some gist of things where they happened for other countries apart from Nigeria. Now, time for us to talk about your health and your well-being in general. Now, I mean, if you know, say they're very important. Say, if you want to lose weight, you don't need to take all those teas them, all those pills them, but you can lose weight on a normal day. Well, that's now why we get this gadget person inside the house. She is a certified nutritionist and fat loss expert. Now, apart from that, she be done the practice for Obodo, Dubai, even India. And then she can decide, say, come on, I must come down Nigeria to make sure, say, I educate Nigeria people on how they're very important, say, they eat better food and they live well. Now, she believes, say, she going to need to make it to make her clients lose inches with the whole health and deliciousness, saying, I get a role to play to actually make sure, say, people actually lose weight the healthy way. And our fat loss program don't go beyond calories and numbers to make you heal your system, spike your metabolism, and give rest to your gastrointestinal problems. Apart from that, if you just look at certificate, you know, say, yes, this is a person where actually sabi work for what she they do. She gets bachelor's for inside applied nutrition for India. She gets master's for global health and management for Scotland. And she is a certified diabetic educator. Now, before you see her, and before we get to know more concerning how to live healthy and how to make sure, say, with our akpu and all the things that we chop, we eat and very well, make we just watch this video on 5 nutritional facts where everyone they agree on. All right, you don't actually watch, and we get a nutritionist in the house, Nitya Hulo.
Yes.
Good to have you in the house.
Good to have you.
All right, Nitya, we get so many questions to ask, especially when it comes to nutrition and diet and even the lifestyle way we need to live. Because now, from with that video, they see, say, we don't see, I'm saying diet is not a good option. So actually, the lifestyle, because a lot of us don't practice dieting. Easy, because that time you go there, easy, like the 1, 2, 3, temptation will come 4 days. After 1 week, we're back to the bad old things we they try to run away from. True. But before we ask you more questions, we're going to need to pass more break now because we get news, top of the hour. But by the time we come back, we'll talk about this nutrition, bloating. Some foods, they will, if we chop them, it will be like, so we'll not forget up.
We need to
talk more on that when we come back from this break. Welcome back. Thanks a bunch of Babake for giving us some news of things where they happen for inside Webodo, Nigeria. Now, still, we get our nutritionist in the house, and she will tell us some tips so you need to know on how to live healthy lifestyle. Nitya Hulo is still with us.
Yes. And just before we back break, we really talk about bloating and certain foods where if we chop up for Nigeria, some of us feel, say, it will make you day, like, say, you know, if you sleep well. One of them, now, some people, they complain, say, if they chop rice or if they chop beans. Say, be like, say, like beans, for example, say, be like, say, they want fat. They make them gassy, or we call it gassy.
Yes.
If you tell us why that kind of food, they cause that kind of thing for our body.
Okay, so basically, beans has something called as phytates and lignans. And these make you feel very gassy, especially if you have it in a very big portion. So the first thing you need to do is obviously cut your portion. And the second thing that I feel is beans are very healthy. So you should never go off beans. But the way you cook it is very, very important. So always what I feel is what's worked for me and many of my clients is soak your beans with a squeeze of lemon in it. Like squeeze a little bit of lemon juice and soak it for 1 hour. Strain it. Raw. And then strain it and then cook it. What happens is the gas-producing phytates and lignans, they actually reduce. You're going to feel a lot better with that. So I think it's mostly about cooking, how you cook your beans and the portion of your beans. Don't do too much of beans. It's not the best thing.
When you say make a reduced portion, they say make you chop till we belly full. You're supposed to eat to your fill. Now you tell me say make I reduce my portion. If I chop 2 or 4 spoons of beans, you tell me say my reduce now to 2. It not go belly full me. I go see the hungry.
I know, but that's the thing. That's what I was telling you, right? You need to try and split your 1 meal into 2. I don't mind if you have this other 2 spoons after 2 to 3 hours, but don't have too much because your stomach is not like a rucksack. You can't keep filling it. It won't digest the food. So always give it a small amount of portion with loads of love. Let it digest it, and after 2 hours, you can have it again.
With loads of love.
Loads of love.
Now, everywhere we turn, you turn to the left, you turn to the right, you hear people talk, say, lose weight, eat little, eat small portion, eat this one, eat vegetable, take fruits so that you go actually get better body. Yes. But we know, say, for inside Obodo, Nigeria, we still get the mentality, just as we're discussing behind the scene. Some people still believe, say, when you have it all, when you join better fat to your body, it means, say, you're living well. So why is it important for us to live well, or rather eat well?
Because, you know, right now, the statistics are so scary that 27% of the deaths in Nigeria are because of diabetes and cardiovascular disease. And most of them are happening to, like, people who are as young as 35 to 40 years. So you can be really healthy and you can think that the society is actually respecting you for the way you're looking. But if your fat percentage is high, you're going to get diabetes, you're going to get BP as early as 50 years. And then you're going to put most of your money into hospital bills. And you're just not going to be healthy. So I think it's not important to be thin. Your body shape doesn't matter. Your fat percentage is what matters. And that's the reason I always weigh my clients only on the fat percentage. It's not your weight. I can be 60, you can be 55, but I can have a very high fat percentage. And that just means that I need to go low on my fats because that's going to increase my cholesterol, put me into cardiac risk. So all of that. So I think it's very, very crucial to know your fat percentage. Mm. It's fine if you're healthy, if you're fat, if you're round, you're curvy, doesn't matter.
So there's nothing wrong with being fat or slim. Your fat percentage.
Exactly.
You just talk fat percentage. Just bring me to the next one where they talk about, speaking of fat percentage, because a lot of Nigerians and a lot of our food, would they use oil to make them?
Mm.
If you be saying a palm oil, whether not red oil, if you be saying a vegetable oil, whether they call them, I've been a granite oil, I've been a local oil, don't they say they sleep. Now, though, when it comes to oil, because now oil, we not say some of the things will feel where they make us add weight to, you know, the kind of oil will they use, but would they see, say, would they get more refined oil?
Yes.
And this refined oil, now the granite oil, that be the vegetable oil, they talk. And would they see, say, a lot of them, they go talk, say, cholesterol free.
I know.
They go tell you, say, good for the heart. They even use a single ringtone for our ear.
Mm-hmm.
Say, this oil, say, they refine them. Say, don't even, they triple refined in some cases.
That's
but
true.
Really, those kind of oil, they actually help our fat percentage.
Ah, not at all. It actually works against you. When they say triple refined, it just means that these groundnuts are taken, they're stripped of nutrients, they're again stripped of nutrients, they're again put into another machine and stripped of nutrients.
Three times.
Three whole times. And we think that what we are getting is nothing but water with many chemicals in it. You know, they bathe it in chemicals, and then these oils that are hydrogenated, they produce something called as trans fats. These trans fats are killer to the heart. Mm-hmm. They are the worst enemy that the heart could ever have. So I think it's very important to choose the right oil. Like you were saying, sometimes not everyone can afford butter. Not everyone can. But what I tell my clients is, you know, you need to invest in your health. That for 2,000 or 1,000 naira that you're putting in the butter, you don't mind going out and eating, buying like tons of Indomie and colas. Huh? So I think it's very important that when it comes to your health, there is investment, but it's going to pay off because you're not going to waste your money on the hospital bills later.
Mm.
So I think that's the reason I feel like you should invest in local food, obviously, in good oils, because oils make up most of your calories. And these oils can be dangerous to your heart. And also, you know, there was this study that was just done that was saying that if you're using one of these sunflower oil, canola oil, it increases your rate of mental degeneration.
Wow.
Yeah, it can put you into something as bad as depression. So, you know, it is very, very crucial to have the right kinds of oils and don't go by these marketing gimmicks that say vitamin E fortified. You cannot spray vitamins and say the oil has got vitamins. You know, that's what they do. They just spray it from the top. So just make sure that you don't go by the big marketing labels. I always tell my clients that anything that looks simple, go for that. Anything that looks too fancy, they're just trying to make you buy it.
A lot of nutritionists, what we don't get for inside the side, they go tell us, say, you need to let go of the Nigerian food and start eating carrots, vegetables, and the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how can you eat well? Now, you talk, say, invest in your local food.
True.
So how can you eat well with our Nigerian food?
So the first thing is, as I said, you need to control your portions. Meat is good, stew is good, rice, beans are good, but everything put together is a lot. So try and cut your portions down. Beans, as I said, make sure that you cook them with lemon in it. They will reduce the gas. Also, stews are so good. Just make sure you don't add so much oil into it. You know, sometimes if you want, and I know that Nigerians love the red color that comes to the stews, I use tomatoes instead. It gives me the same color. You know, so instead of going for the palm oil...
No, but I was still get tomato. Now, tomato, they still make them.
Yes, tomatoes and onions, I know, is like very, very crucial too. But many people, they add a lot more of palm oil just to give you that color.
Okay.
So, you know, if you want to go low on your calories and you don't want to get it from the oil, use tomatoes instead.
Only tomato without oil?
Without oil, try it. It's not that bad.
Some people actually do without oil.
I know. Yes, some people and now you know there was. I was just seeing yesterday that there was the spinach fufu that they made. Oh my God, I'm going to try.
Spinach fufu.
Yes.
As in ugu fufu.
Exactly.
They will blend the vegetable.
They will blend vegetable.
Fire, keep on turning it.
They add like 1 teaspoon of oats powder to give that the texture. You know, the thickness. Try stuff like that. These are all very local. Also, I think something that people don't buy, or at least I know many people don't, is tiger nuts. You know, tiger nuts in when I was in UK, they used to sell one pack of tiger nuts for like £60.
And it's that expensive.
It's that expensive. And over here, the Malam sells it for like 50 naira.
Mm-hmm.
And if tiger nuts are one of the superfoods that Nigerians are not aware of, because it really helps with diabetes. It's very good for weight loss. It's very good for your skin.
Now, you're speaking of weight loss and dieting, because some dieting mistakes, the way a lot of us, they do. Mm-hmm. Now, some people go, see, when you don't chop finish, if you want to make your body break down the food fast, chew gum.
Ah.
Yeah, they say just keep chewing gum. So if you chew gum, the thing will make calm, your body will just work out fast. How true that won't be?
Yes. Chewing gum is okay, but don't go overboard on it, because chewing gum actually gives you a lot of bloating. People don't know that.
Ah.
Because you're taking in a lot of air, right? And this air will make you pass more gas, make you burp a lot more. And also there are many people who think sugar-free is the best. Like, you know, they have this thing, their mentality is such, oh, it's sugar-free, let's have it. But sugar-free gums especially, they have something called as xylitol. And that ferments in your colon and gives you more gas. It really disrupts your digestion, I'm telling you. So anyone who's chewing like more than 3 gums a day, not good.
Now, when you talk of fizzy drinks, you just talk of sugar-free. Fizzy drinks, this one are mineral, what would they call them? Yeah. Where they talk, say, oh, sugar-free, sugar-free. And I know, say, one of the substitutes they use for these drinks is aspartame.
Uh-huh.
Now, this aspartame, it better pass the regular sugar, what would they take for the normal fizzy drinks?
Mm-hmm. No, see, aspartame is actually quite dangerous. Aspartame has been linked to cancer.
Wow.
Yeah, and because they're not adding sugar, they add a lot more of these, you know, stabilizers and things that make it more tasty. So, you know, if you're going for diet cola that most people do, you know, like this diet Pepsi,
diet
and
they'll
be like, oh, it's diet Pepsi, it's not got sugar. But it's actually worse than having just a cola. So you might as well just pick up a cola bottle and have it, because, again, diet cola is linked to diabetes.
So there's this new trend now. We just want to educate Nigerians. There's this new trend of people taking diet tea. Is it healthy?
No, it's not. It's just not. I was just checking somewhere that, you know, you get these diet teas for as low as 2,000 Naira.
Oh, yeah.
And they tell you 7 kg off in a week.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just thinking, how are people buying into this? How are people buying
into
this?
They are.
It is very sad. It is very sad because they have something called, they have a laxative in all these diet teas, because their main focus is to make you lose weight. They have this laxative. These laxatives are great if you're constipated. You're not supposed to take it more than twice a week. These teas have it every single day. So you're going to lose the 7 kg, but that's just going to be muscle loss and water loss. So you're going to have very saggy skin. You'll probably have hair loss. Your nails will chip. And you won't feel good, you know. I think the main reason why you need to go on a diet is to be healthy and to be fit and toned. When people look at you in a dress, they should be like, oh, wow, she's looking good.
Fantastic.
You don't, you can't just feel weak and, you know, have those bags under your eyes. So it's never about weight loss. I think, as I said, it's about feeling good about yourself and what you wear.
Wow, because time don't go, we just need one or two tips from you, from amazing information. Now, just tell us one or two things what we do in terms of the lifestyle or eating well, or even trying to watch it with the chop. What can be those two major things where they're very important?
Okay. The first thing is chew your food. Chew your food as much as you can.
So I should chew eba or pounded
yam? No, not eba.
Okay, I can swallow that, right?
No, not the swallows. Swallows, you can do it.
Okay.
But like the rice, you know, because I think we are so busy making money and we have this whole let's grab and go. You know, that kind of a lifestyle. We don't even sit down for 5 minutes to eat our food. And that's when I tell my clients, you know, whenever you're eating food, please make sure that you give good vibrations to your food. Be thankful for the food on your plate and then eat it with peace in your mind. Not that, oh my God, I need to make like something in the evening. I need to do this. I need to go home. Give yourself that 5 to 10 minutes. So always chew your food. It really helps. Digestion starts in the mouth.
Okay.
So don't miss that part of it.
Chew your food, that's one.
Chew your food. Second thing, which is not diet related, but it really leads to a lot of bloating and digestion issues, is wearing these shapers. There are so many who wear these shapers.
I used to wear it. Oh, yeah. It's wrong to wear the body shapers?
No, it's fine to wear them, but you need to leave your body a little bit, maybe once or twice a week, you know?
Okay.
Because I feel like over here, everyone is wearing shapers and they have an amazing body. But, you know, the shapers, they actually... they squeeze your intestines.
Yes, they do.
You eat the food. The food doesn't have place to go. So you start getting these acid reflux and the burps. That's the reason. Just let your body a little loose. So that's the reason when it comes to a diet, like, you know, the video that we were watching, it's not just about your food. It's about what you think, what you wear, what you eat, what you feel.
Wow.
So that's, fantastic. It's a holistic change.
Wow, yes. So much information.
That's amazing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So thank much. You. Chewing your food and making sure so you relax on your body magic. I've been a body shaper, I've been a body ghetto. With a lot of women nowadays, who don't they wear, who they buy, who they... Let's make we even sleep with them.
I should talk to stay away from pills, stay away from all those diet teas, and just eat normal and eat healthy.
No, eat healthy, exactly.
How can they follow you on Instagram if people need to get in touch with you?
Yes, so my Instagram handle is Nitya Hulur, NitayaHullur. I have a Facebook page as well, the same Nitya Hulur, Nutrition Heals. And should I give them the number?
Well, if they follow you, they can actually ask
Yes,
for
they
your
can
number.
Ask me for the number. Yes, that's easier. So you can follow me on Instagram. And like I said, it's more about your gut and the way you feel. It's not about losing weight always.
Thank
Just focus
you.
On that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Well, I love it.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.